In the off chance that you somehow get cast as a Daily Show correspondent, you're probably going to end up to be pretty successful. Since Jon Stewart took over the Daily Show, over 70 correspondents have appeared alongside him. Probably 70. I don't know, I didn't really count. It's a pretty long list. But of those, who has become the most successful? Which Daily Show correspondent is the GOAT? Here's a quick rundown of some of the most successful Daily Show correspondents of all time. Samantha Bee, Jeff Ross, Hasan Minhaj, Steve Carell, Jordan Klepper, Jessica Williams, John Oliver, Stephen Colbert, Trevor Noah, former WWE champion and probably still hardcore champion Mick Foley, Josh Gad, Ed Helms, and Olivia Munn. But this is stiff competition, so I'm going to select the six that I think have a chance to win this award. Though she started on Nickelodeon in 2006, Jessica Williams went on to become a Daily Show correspondent in 2012, hired as the youngest ever. She worked on the show till 2016 for over 140 episodes. Williams has always had this style of being both confident and awkward, and it really worked for her. She attempted to break into Hollywood and has been somewhat successful. I love Jessica James, and her role in Booksmart was absolutely fantastic. Miss Fine, well done. She's also got an upcoming part in the new Fantastic Beasts movie, whenever that comes out. Lots of potential, but still hasn't quite broken through the way that I'm hoping she does. Okay, let's be honest. Easily the best looking person to ever work for The Daily Show. I mean, look at that beard. Hired by Jon Stewart in 2014, Minhaj was actually asked to come in to audition in person after submitting his audition tape and panicked because that tape was the only material he had. Luckily for him, Bill Maher and Ben Affleck got into an argument about Islam on Maher's show, and Minhaj used that as material for an audition bit he titled Batman vs. Bill Maher. Minhaj actually went on to host his own Netflix show for a few years, Patriot Act, really, really fantastic, and is now booked to be in season 2 of Apple TV's The Morning Show. That's right, because they canceled Patriot Act for some reason. I will say, Hasan makes a pretty strong entrant into this competition, but let's see who else deserves to be here. Trevor Noah has the distinction of being the only person on this list to have already had his own late night talk show before even being hired by Jon Stewart. That's right, he actually hosted a show called Tonight with Trevor Noah, and it aired on Mnet. Never heard of it? Yeah, me neither. Noah joined The Daily Show as a correspondent in 2014, and just a year later took over for Jon Stewart as the show's new host. Since taking on hosting duties, Noah has won an Emmy, received several other nominations for his work on the show, and was named one of the most powerful people in New York media by The Hollywood Reporter. And on top of that, he was also named one of the top 100 most influential people in the world by Time Magazine. I honestly didn't know about a lot of these accolades beforehand, but it definitely puts Noah in the running to win this competition. John Oliver joined the show in 2006 because Ricky Gervais, who had never met him but liked his material, recommended him to Jon Stewart, so Stewart hired him on the spot. Over the next 7 years, Oliver received Emmy nominations for his writing on the show, actually took home the award in 2009, 2011, and 2012. Comedy Central offered him his own late-night talk show, but they had competition from HBO, and that's where Oliver landed. This was just a few months after Oliver spent the summer of 2013 covering The Daily Show hosting duties while Jon Stewart was away. The John Oliver Show premiered in April 2014 and shows no signs of slowing down, honestly, because it's amazing, and also because it's won an Emmy like every single year. Jon certainly has an incredibly strong case for being the most successful correspondent of all time, but this is a stacked group. Ah yes, Jon Stewart's one true rival. It's actually crazy now to look back on the fact that the Colbert Report was actually a spin-off of Colbert's work on The Daily Show. Colbert worked as a correspondent on The Daily Show for 8 years before landing his own spin-off. The Colbert Report went on for 10 seasons and is often thought of as one of Comedy Central's most successful shows of all time. It's also probably the way most of us first learned who Stephen Colbert even was. In 2015, Colbert took over for David Letterman as the new host of The Late Show, and that's basically been where he stayed. Colbert hasn't bounced around Hollywood as much as some of the other competitors on this list, but he's put together an incredibly successful career as a stable man who can lead his own show. Carell signed on as a correspondent in 1999 and remained with the show for the next 6 years. He actually had multiple recurring segments on the show, and it seemed like during that time he really refined his unique comedic style. Now, I'm sure Jon Stewart is a great guy to work for, but in 2005, Carell would give him a run for his money. That year, NBC debuted their new workplace comedy, The Office, led by Steve Carell, and a bunch of other people who you've probably never heard of. Wow, actually, I guess maybe I should do a list on this group too. Carell played Michael Scott for 7 seasons before leaving as The Office ended after 7 seasons and definitely didn't keep going. After leaving the show, Carell jumped to Hollywood, where he usually ends up playing scumbags or sad dads. Carell is an absolute stud who absolutely deserves to be in this conversation. Now that the field is set, it's time to select a winner. Who is deemed the greatest Daily Show correspondent of all time through completely made-up criteria that I may or may not have been clear about? Your winner of the Daily Show MVP award goes to... Trevor Noah. Yeah, of course. It's got to be the guy who took over the show. I mean, everybody on this list deserves to be here, but my God. Trevor Noah had some pretty large shoes to fill, and somehow he did it. The show's been pretty successful ever since Jon left. That's mostly because of how talented Trevor Noah and his entire staff are, making a seamless transition into his version of The Daily Show. Congratulations to all the nominees, I'm sure. As they always say, it's just an honor to be nominated. Congratulations to Trevor for actually winning, because that's way more impressive. I will say, though, if this list proves anything, it's that if you get hired on The Daily Show as a correspondent, you're probably going to become massively successful. Except for Mary Birdsong. Sorry, Mary.
Oh, so stupid. This was so stupid.